jacket.
I know, like, the basics.
Excuse me.
Good morning.
We're back over Zacho now, and I wanted to show you how alive this city is. We're going to take you down the main street, and you see some of the people up close, I hope, but just give you an idea of some of the activity. And imagine, remember, 2 weeks or 2 months ago, there was nothing here. Absolutely nothing here. Absolute terrorism, fear on the part of the few people that were here, and a very, very big Iraqi presence. And this is what your Marines feel good about. They've been able to restore basically a city to life and give these people a sense of security and stability that they just have never experienced before. There's the main part of the city there. You can see the stores and the shops are open. There they are. All these people down there are Kurds that were in the mountains not too long ago. All these kids were up in the mountains freezing. Now they're smiling and now they're healthy. It's pretty neat. MSSG 24 had a lot to do with this. They came into this town. There was nothing else. There was nothing behind us in terms of allied capabilities. They set up a water purification unit. They provided the first fresh water that the town had in a long time. They provided medical care, dental care, and really were the first real civic action program that this town had. For the first 2 weeks we were here until the real more robust capability followed on behind us. We're now leaving Zacho, you can see it off to your left, and we're proceeding down the road to Baghdad. One thing that Saddam Hussein spent his money well on is the roads. They're absolutely tip-top shape. He didn't do it for the people, he did it because it enabled his army to move around. What you're looking at now is the major intersection that takes you to Baghdad. We'll go around it. This is a key intersection that we would have had to occupy if we had gone into the city of Dai Hook. To your left of your screen now, where the orange truck is going, is the road to Baghdad, which is about 3.5 to 4 hours from here. And just down there, you're looking due south now. About 5 miles down there is the Iraqi army. That's where their first positions are. It's kind of a key intersection, and one that we studied very hard when we thought we were going to have to come in here and occupy the terrain. As it turns out, a political agreement was forged with the Iraqis, which did not make it necessary for us to do that. But had we had to, we would have done so very easily and very capably. Now, this valley that you see now coming from right to left is holds the city of Dohuk, spelled D-O-H-U-K. It's a city, it's a Kurdish town. It's a city that was abandoned by the Kurds during the Iraqi persecution. Normally holds 350,000 people. About 2 months ago when we got here, there were less than 5,000 people in this town. It was a ghost town. Happy to report now that we've got about 175,000 people back in here. More coming back in every day. Electricity's been restored. Water's been restored. A lot of the health services have been restored. And the Kurds have come back, and the Iraqis very intelligently have left. And things are more or less returning to normal. The headquarters of the Joint Task Force, General Gardner's headquarters, is here in Dohuk. And I spend the night there with him as well, as a representative of the forward command element of the BU. And we are prepared with BLT 28 and the 3rd Battalion of the 325th U.S. Army Airborne. Those two battalions are poised at either side of town to come in if need be. Kind of showing you an aerial view from a ridgeline that was occupied by the Iraqi army as well, overlooking the town. You see this little dirt road that's passing below us is how the Iraqi army resupplied all their positions up here. They're not here now, but they were in strength. And you can see what a dominating position it is to occupy this terrain up here. The modern building that you see below you is the Saddam Hussein Hospital, a very modern hospital. It is still run by the Iraqi health services and was not damaged during the war. The dam that you see in the distance was built by the Japanese about 8 years ago and provides all the water for the irrigation of the valley that we just flew over and produced such abundance of wheat.